Many people think Leonard Peltier's story begins with the death of two FBI agents and ends with him in federal prison since his wrongful conviction in 1977. But that is only part of the story of this American Indian movement leader who continues to this day to fight for the rights of his people.
Everyone who ever died without a voice or a prayer or a hope or a chance.
This fight began long before Leonard was born, and many American Indians have been killed or falsely imprisoned by an overreaching FBI and U.S. government.
Had to pay for the murders of their agents.
You're a railroad.
Oh, definitely. If I...
Are you guilty of anything?
I'm guilty of trying to stop the injustices that are happening to Indian people in Indian territories and in Indian country.
From the 1887 Dawes Act and the founding of the Bureau of Indian Affairs to the treatment Leonard received after the shooting and during his trial, these are just a few examples in the long list of atrocities committed by the United States.
It is an honor to come before you as a spokesman for my people, the American Indians of the United States of America. In these United States of America, this great country of ours, we American Indians, we can be anything we want to be, except American Indians.
Leonard Peltier was sentenced to life in prison based on false FBI statements, coerced witness testimony, and deliberately withheld ballistics reports. The FBI did this while claiming AIM members were domestic terrorists and while they ignored staggering murder rates on the Pine Ridge Reservation. Since the FBI nor the Justice Department will ever right this wrong, it falls to the President of the United States to grant Leonard his freedom. And today that person is Donald Trump, who is experiencing firsthand how politically involved the FBI has become.
As an American citizen, I'm nervous and discontent that people would have those kinds of lack of impartiality and bad animus as displayed in those emails, and that they would have gone so far as to try to use that dossier to discredit the campaign. I think that's going beyond just having political views.
Since his conviction, every U.S. president has ignored Leonard Peltier's pleas for help, including Bill Clinton, who pardoned Mark Rich, who was indicted on 65 criminal counts, including violating sanctions by the United States against Iran during the Iran hostage crisis.
Well, I don't I don't have a position I can announce yet. I think I believe there is a new application for him in there. And when I have time after the election's over, I'm going to review all the remaining executive clemency applications and, see what the merits dictate. I will try to do what I think the right thing to do is based on the evidence. And I've never had the time actually to sit down myself and review that case. I know it's very important to a lot of people, maybe on both sides of the issue. And I think I owe it to them to give it an honest look-see. So part of my responsibilities in the last 10 weeks of office after the election will be to review the requests for pardons and executive clemencies and give them a fair hearing. And I pledge to do that.
And you will give an answer in his case?
Oh, yeah. I'll decide one way or the other.
During the George W. Bush presidency, he and the House passed a bill that pardoned all members of the U.S. administration for any war crimes that may be brought against them in the future.
Ordinarily, we don't do a question 2 days in a row, but this is important enough to be an exception. The House just passed President Bush's bill to redefine the treatment of detainees, and the Senate's expected to do the same thing tomorrow. Buried deep inside this legislation is a provision that will pardon President Bush and all the members of his administration of any possible crimes connected with the torture and mistreatment of detainees, dated all the way back to September 11, 2001. At least President Nixon had Gerald Ford to do his dirty work. President Bush is trying to pardon himself.
How is that possible? And even Barack Obama denied Leonard clemency, but instead granted it to Oscar Lopez Rivera, who was part of a Puerto Rican paramilitary group that set off 120 bombs in New York and in Obama's hometown of Chicago. All these pardons were authorized, but Leonard Peltier continues to sit in prison, all but forgotten.
Passing thought. Not so passing, but I'll take this opportunity to publicly, once again, for the last few months, passionate appeal has been made to President Barack Obama to use the power of the executive office to free my friend and our leader, Leonard Peltier.
Leonard's appeal for clemency is supported by three former U.S. attorneys, James Reynolds, Ramsey Clark, and Cynthia Doone. Reynolds even supervised a key part of Leonard's prosecution and is now calling for his release. Both Clark and Doone have written letters asking for Leonard's clemency. Leonard also has support from 7 Nobel Peace Prize winners and dozens of human rights leaders from around the world. Join us on our upcoming podcast as we explore all details of this case and the events that led to the shootout. The deaths of FBI agents Jack Kohler and Ronald Williams should not be forgotten, but the treatment of Leonard Peltier during his trial and to this day is another stain on the history of the FBI and the United States. So President Trump, you want to make America great again? Then start by doing something for the American Indian that Obama, Clinton, and Bush did not have the courage to do, and free Leonard Peltier from his wrongful imprisonment. In this podcast coming in February, Archangels of Justice investigators Salvatore Rastrelli and Ira Robbins, along with other experts for Leonard's defense team, will expose the perjured testimony, false affidavits, exclusion of exculpatory evidence, as well as the fabricated evidence by the FBI in order to prosecute Leonard for murders he didn't commit. So you don't miss any episodes, subscribe today to the Archangels of Justice Case Files podcast feed on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, SoundCloud, or your favorite podcast app. To get the latest updates from Archangels of Justice, follow and like us on Facebook at Archangels of Justice. You can also follow us on Twitter at Archangel Pod.